Please subscribe our channel Knowledge Distributor for latest technology and smartphone videos.
You buy iPhone 8 Plus or iPhone XR. That is the topic of today's video. Neither of these are $1,000 phones, and the intention of this video is to help that person out who's looking to upgrade and needs to know if it's worth it to come from an 8 Plus to an XR. And number two is that person who's trying to decide, should I buy the $699 iPhone 8 Plus or the $750 iPhone XR? So let's get started. Okay, so let's talk about the key specifications between both of these. A 5.5 inch LCD 1920 by 1080p standard resolution panel on the iPhone 8 Plus, 12 megapixel dual camera, 2160p at 60 frames per second, 3 gigabytes of RAM, an Apple A11 Bionic chipset, 2691 milliamp hour battery, Touch ID, security, home button. Over here for the iPhone XR, we're looking at a 6.1 inch Retina display. This is liquid Retina, 828 by 1792 pixels. And this is a 12 megapixel single camera on the rear with AI Smart HDR for portrait mode. Shoots up to 2160p in 4K, 3 gigabytes of RAM, Apple A12 Bionic chipset, 2942 milliamp hour battery. So those are the key specifications between both of these. The XR definitely, besides the display, is ahead of the iPhone 8 Plus in the specifications department. So I want to quickly note that they're both running iOS 12.0.1 as the recording of this video, and both of these phones will have very long software support well into the 2020s. So if you get either of these, you will be good when it comes to software updates. Okay, so which one has the better design overall? Now, the iPhone XR, you're firstly going to notice, is a much thicker device, over 8 millimeters, this one at 7.5. They feel about the same in the hand when it comes to the glass back. Both support wireless charging. The camera hump is a little bit thicker here for the iPhone XR than what you're going to find on the iPhone XS Max. Dual camera, and it's even thinner. However, I find the camera quality better for the XR. Now, the sides do show a little bit of a bigger power button for the XR, and you also do have the same volume rocker and silent switch about in the same place. Now, at the bottom, the holes are a little bit less for the iPhone XR. Overall, this just feels like an iPhone X version of the iPhone 8 Plus, and I think it wins the design category because it just feels more modern, more compact, and I like that single lens. It just looks kind of minimal. Reminds me of the Google Pixel 3, for example, or even the older iPhone 7 and iPhone 8. All right, so let's discuss displays. Now, the iPhone 8 Plus does offer a 1920 by 1080p 5.5 inch Retina display. This guy is 16 by 9, so every application for the iPhone 8 Plus is perfectly optimized. There's no things that are like off, that are like cutting off on the screen, so everything just seems perfectly well suited to work on this device when it comes to applications. That's a great thing. This also goes in landscape mode for the iPhone 8 Plus, so it can feel like a little mini iPad, something you can't do on the iPhone XR. That's a nice touch for the 8 Plus. And mostly what you notice here is that the display is just sharper and it looks more like a standard panel you're going to find like on a laptop even, or an iMac, or any kind of computer. It just has that standard feel to it, but very sharp on that 1080p. It also brings True Tone to the iPhone 8 Plus as well. So the most refined, you know, 5.5 inch they made. Now, the iPhone XR is everything that the iPhone 8 Plus is besides the sharpness. It's just as bright. It does give you the same color accuracy, the same True Tone. And seriously, the only difference is that sharpness. But when it comes to the design, you will notice that aspect ratio is a lot different as well. A lot of applications are not optimized yet for the display on the iPhone XR, and that's going to be a little bit of time before it is. Overall, I do think that the iPhone 8 Plus wins this round when it comes to sharpness. But other things like how it looks, I think the iPhone XR's display looks better in terms of design, but the actual panel quality itself is better for the 8 Plus. The bezels are also a little bit thicker than the iPhone XS and XS Max, but they're not as thick as these bezels right here. So the XR does get some points, but the quality itself is better for the iPhone 8 Plus. Okay, so in terms of speed, which one is better? The 8 Plus rocks the A11 Bionic chipset, and that chip was already faster than pretty much everything on the market. And the A12 Bionic just takes it up a notch for the iPhone XR. You also get a notch right there, pun not intended. But let's go ahead and come out of here. The way you operate these is much different though. And the swipe gesture, I think, just feels a little faster than that home button. But still, that home button is pretty reliable. But you can see on these applications that everyday use is basically not that much of a difference. I skipped Jetpack Joyride. Let's go and open that one up. You can see even games open pretty quickly there. 48 plus iMovie. And I'll do a proper speed test in the future. We're just going to open a few applications here. Let me go and open the cameras up. 3, 2, 1. And you can see very similar performance. So day-to-day use as it stands right now, it's not going to be that noticeable. It's going to be a couple years or maybe even 3 years before the A12 does show it's a little bit more powerful than the Apple A11. Okay, so here is your Geekbench scores. For those of you who are wondering, 4283 for the single on the 8 Plus and 4780 for the iPhone XR, and a little bit of a better score here on the XR, 11,143 for the Multi and 10,551 on the Multi for the 8 Plus. Now, yes, the XR is a little bit ahead here of the 8 Plus, but keep in mind, these scores are ridiculous already for the 8 Plus. So this is more power than you would ever need, although technically speaking, the XR is a more powerful smartphone than the iPhone 8 Plus. Okay, so which one is better in terms of software? And there really is no winner here. They're basically a tie. They're just a different way of operating. Now, the iPhone XR operates on a gesture-based OS. The iPhone 8 Plus operates on a button-based OS right here. Both of them are iOS, so the core applications that you've been used to for quite some time are the same. However, if you're used to swiping up from the bottom, now you got to swipe up from the top for the control center. That's going to take some getting used to if you have an 8 Plus right now. They offer iOS 12, very fast, refined software. You do have the new screen time mode. You also have Siri shortcuts. In addition to that, you get new photo enhancements. Siri also gets more languages, I believe, and you also do get Memoji on this phone, the iPhone XR, as well as Animoji. So if you're into that text messaging, Face ID type stuff, this is definitely going to be the better buy for you. But overall, I got to call them a tie in software because it's going to come down to your subjective preference, whether you like this gesture thing or you like the home button. Okay, so in terms of their cameras, they do have some strengths and weaknesses on both. Number one, the iPhone 8 Plus has the strength of the telephoto lens, which allows you to get better zoom shots than the iPhone XR, and it could do object detection in portrait mode. However, the iPhone XR has a better primary lens than the iPhone 8 Plus, and that might be the selling point right there. They both can shoot in 4K 60, but there's a huge separator on this one, and that is the Smart HDR, which is actually very effective for the iPhone XR, combining multiple exposures to get you the best shot. So the point and shoot winner to me is the iPhone XR. I'm getting better photos over the iPhone 8 Plus, and unless you need zoom and object detection, I think that the iPhone XR does present you with the better camera. But go ahead and judge for yourself. They both got a similar software. I'm going to show you some samples right now side by side, and let me know which one you think is better when it comes to their shooters. Okay, so when it comes to the battery life, which one is the better device? And I can tell you right now that the XR is seeming to be the better one so far. Lower resolution display on a more efficient chipset seems to be giving me better battery life so far on the iPhone XR. Now, Apple does claim that this phone should get at least like an hour or so better than this device, but we'll have to do a proper test to see if that's true. But this one so far, I'm liking the battery life for the XR. So if you're looking for great battery life, the XR would probably be my pick between these two. However, you can still get through a full day quite easily on the 8 Plus. So this shouldn't be the only factor. But if you're looking for the absolute best battery life, you want the XR here. Okay, so for those of you who are dreaming about the headphone jack coming back, not today. The XR doesn't bring it back either. But with that being said, it does give you dual speaker, stereo speakers on the XR as well as pretty much every other iPhone. And I can tell you right now, the audio sounds the same. I've been testing them both, and I'm seeing no difference so far with the audio that's coming out of these external speakers. And that is to say, it's pretty good. It's pretty full sounding, clear. And I think you shouldn't choose either of these just based on audio. They both do a stellar job when it comes to the music that comes out the external speakers. Okay, guys, so let's talk about price really quickly. The iPhone 8 Plus starts at $699. The iPhone XR starts at $749. Now, the iPhone 8 Plus, the one you really want, is 256 gigs because that gives you a lot more storage. That one goes up to $849. Now, you can get a sweet spot iPhone XR at $799 for 128 gigabytes. You want 256 gigabytes, you're going up to $899. So these are pretty close in the price. I think that's why this comparison is so important right here. But I think for the storage at 128 gigabyte, that's the sweet spot. And I think that's the better pricing over the iPhone 8 Plus, because $699, 64 gigabytes is really not enough if you're going to be investing for this phone for the long term. So in conclusion, should you buy the iPhone 8 Plus or the iPhone XR? We have a definitive winner. The one you should buy of these two is the iPhone XR. Allow me to explain why. Based on the results of this entire video that you just watched quickly, the specs go to the iPhone XR. It's a better spec'd out, higher tech phone. It's gonna last longer with that A12 Bionic chipset. Software is a tie on both of these, so the 8 Plus doesn't get a win there. Design looks more modern and gets rid of these chunky bezels, so that goes to the XR. Display is better quality and no notch for the 8 Plus, so display win goes to the 8 Plus, but that's its only win. Speed and performance to the XR, Geekbench to the XR. The camera, because of the smart HDR, goes to the iPhone XR. Also, just being a better photo taker overall and video taker on the XR. The iPhone XR gets the win on battery life, and it's a tie in audios. So the final results are 6 wins to the XR, 3 ties, and 1 to the iPhone 8 Plus. And with all that being said, they would have tied in phone call as well, IP67, water and dust resistance, Bluetooth 5.0, and their band support. So overall, it's the iPhone XR. It's only the display that goes to the 8 Plus, and maybe not having a notch. That's a personal subjectivity, feeling, personal preference. If you guys found this video helpful, entertaining, informing, enjoying, do me a favor, click that like button for me. And if you are new here, consider subscribing for more. Any questions, comments, concerns on the all new XR, let me know down below in the comment section. Nick here, helping you to master your technology. Thank you very much for watching. Be sure to be well. I will catch you all in the next episode, and peace.